Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over how to insert page numbers inside of a document. Let's go back to the Pride and Prejudice document we used in the college writing lesson a few weeks ago, because this will be a good place to insert some page numbers. So to insert basic page numbers, just go up to the Insert menu, go to Page Number, top of page, right side, and hit Close Header and Footer. And you can see that it only took a few seconds to type in 1 at the top right, 2 at the top right, 3 at the top right, etc. So I'm going to go back to the top, and let's go over some of these page numbering options that you have. So if I go back to Insert and go under Page Number, first of all, it's the location that can be changed. So if I want my page numbers at the top of the page, right here at top of page, I can have them to the left, to the center, or to the right. I can also go to the bottom of the page and have my page numbers to the left, to the center, or to the right. If I go under Format Page Numbers, I can have different types of page numbers at the top. I can have either a 1, 2, 3, an ABC, or some Roman numerals, kind of like what you would have in a preface. But let's try this one right now with the dashes. I'm going to select that and say OK. So as you can see here, I have my page number surrounded by dashes. This makes the page number a little bit more distinct from all of the other text in the document. So if I scroll down, you can see the 2 and the 3, etc. Another option I could do is go to Insert and go to Header, Edit Header, because I want to be inside the header when I'm making this change, except I want to be over to the right. So I'm going to go to Home and hit the right align and go back to Insert. And under Page Number, let's put Current Position and put this accent bar right here. So I could have my page number inserted here with the word page and a bar before it. So if I scroll up, you can see that the page is changing and the page number is still in there with the dashes on either side of it. If I go to Page Number, Format Page Numbers, and change that back to just the regular number and say OK, now I have page 1, page 2, page 3. And that is just a different look that you can give to your page numbers. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. Another thing I would like to have at the top of the screen is maybe my chapter. So with chapter 1, I'm just going to backspace that and go over to the home ribbon and go here to multi-level list. And I'm going to select the last one for chapters. I'm going to go down and do the same thing for chapter 2 and for chapter 3. Now, if I scroll back up to the top, and go back to Insert, and go to Page Numbers, and go to Format Page Numbers, I now have this option that says Include Chapter Number. I'm going to check that. I'm also going to set my number format back to 123 because I won't need the dashes after you see this. And then I'm going to click OK. So now if I look at the top, I can see 1-1. What does that mean? That means I'm on Chapter 1 because I formatted it in that multi-level list as a chapter. And then I can also see the page number that I'm on. So if I scroll down to the next page, you can see the 1-2. And on the third page, you can see 2-3. Because if I scroll down on that page, you can see that chapter 2 is on that page. What I would like to do is hit Control Enter to insert a page break so that my chapter appears on a different page. And then I can delete that space. So now page 4 is chapter 2, but page 3 is now chapter 1. Which is probably a little bit more readable. So if I scroll down to chapter 3, you can see the same thing, 3-6, but the chapter is further down on the page. So again, I'm going to hit Control Enter right before chapter 3 so that chapter 3 appears on its own page. So you can now see 3-7 and 2-6 for chapter 2, page 6. You'll also notice that the page number is keeping a running tally on what page number it's on, which is good because they're still sequentially the page numbers in the book. Now, if I go to Header and I go to Edit Header, let's go before the chapter number and put the word chapter. It doesn't matter which header I'm editing because it will edit it for every header that is on the page. So if I close the header and footer and scroll up, you can see that I'm on chapter 2, page 6, and scroll down, I'm on chapter 3, page 7. So hopefully that gives you a good introduction of some options you have with your page numbering. To get rid of those, I can go back to the Insert ribbon, go to Page Numbering, and hit Remove Page Numbers. But the word chapter is still staying up here because the word chapter is in my header. So I'm just going to go to Header, Remove Header, and I've removed everything now. Hopefully that gives you a good introduction of some of your options with page numbering, and I hope that you learned something new today, and we look forward to seeing you again next time.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.